I made this weapon concept art video 9 years ago, and I wanted to see if I could display them in an art gallery that I recently built in my Minecraft world. But I got two problems. One, they're pretty old, so I'll have to update them. And two, a flat image on the wall just isn't cool enough for these. That's where BlockBench comes in. This is a free 3D low-poly modeling program that you can use for making custom items and textures in Minecraft. But that's for later in the video, so for now, let's get into redesigning these weapons. Heading into Procreate, I knew I didn't want to drastically change anything about the designs. I'm basically trying to exaggerate certain aspects to give them better silhouettes, while also simplifying any unnecessary details or shapes. This will make things a lot easier when I go to model them, just being able to see how it all fits together cleanly. For the staff specifically, this is one that I probably changed the most, purely because I remember when I did the original design, I pictured it a lot more twisted, but I couldn't really figure out how to do that at the time, so it's much closer to how I originally would have wanted it now. I can see the animation degree kicking in with how simple I colored everything, but again, it's all to make it as clear as possible to be used as reference. Now that I have all four weapon designs polished, it's time to finally enter BlockBench. Okay, I realized that I didn't actually explain in the intro that I'm a complete beginner to BlockBench and kind of 3D in general. I learned 3D a bit in my animation program, but it wasn't BlockBench and I also was not good at it. So this is all kind of new to me, but to prepare for this video, I did look up tutorials and I wanted to recommend this one YouTuber, Arts by Kev. He was the main person that I learned from, and he has so many helpful tutorials for beginners, and he also has more advanced stuff too. If you were at all interested in trying this yourself, I provided a link in the description to a playlist I made of all the tutorials I watched, not just by him, other people as well. But yeah, hopefully that helps if you're wanting to give that a go. Alright, so I'm starting with the blue shattered sword. And I found out that I can put the reference drawing directly onto the workspace, which was super nice. A lot of the beginning, I kind of just fumbled around with camera views and the different transform options. One of the first issues I encountered was that I couldn't rotate things exactly how I wanted. Apparently, that's one of the limitations with Minecraft models. Like here, I'm trying to make the exact shape of the reference, but it really just wasn't possible, or at least I didn't know how to. So I ended up changing it to something much simpler, and I had a much better time after that. Really, the biggest thing I learned was just working with what I could and not entirely relying on the drawing reference. You can see I made the shape of the blade out of a bunch of cubes. Keep that in mind for later, because I did eventually figure out a better way to get the shape without it being so tedious. Because right now I'm like copying and pasting a whole bunch of different cubes to make up this blade and it's just too much. Alright, I'm gonna go through these next models a little faster because I'm starting to get the hang of it and you don't need to hear me ramble about every little challenge that I had, which, trust me, I did have a lot. The staff was by far my favorite one to model, probably just because of the organic shape of it. Nothing had to be like perfectly symmetrical, so I could really just focus all of my energy into getting that shape as close as possible to my reference. I could already feel myself getting faster with moving around the program, so this one really didn't end up taking that long. Next, the crystal wand. So this one was small. I decided to go a lot more detailed. Things like having the crystals protrude slightly out of their sockets or having the cloth cleanly wrapped around the handle. I also finally learned how to organize the shapes in the outline, which will make things so much easier in the future to know where everything is and easily click on different sections of the weapon. It's basically like just organizing my layers. And finally, we have the overgrown cutlass. This is where I could really feel all of my learning kind of come together. Oh, and remember when I said the first sword I made the blade out of like all those cubes? Well, here's where I actually figured out a better method to get that shape. I made one big plane that took up the space I would need, and then in the texture of the model, I erased parts of it to pretty much just draw out the shape I wanted for the blade. I don't know if that makes sense. I guess the only downside now is that it's like paper thin. So like if you're trying to look at the sword from the side, you wouldn't really see anything, but for my purposes, it totally works. There's not much to say really during this section. It's really just like doing pixel art. And I'm really tired of talking already. So here, have a speed paint. It's sort of my thing. Now we finally move on to the final step, which is getting these weapons in-game. All I need to do is make a resource pack, which I'm not really gonna show how to do in this video, but if there's enough interest, I'd be happy to make a tutorial in the future. Anyways, let's check out the final results. And that is the end of the video. Let me know which was your favorite weapon of the four. This video took me so much longer than I thought it would, honestly mainly from figuring out how to structure and edit this video, but I'm very proud of how it all turned out. I'd love to fill this art gallery with more models and art, and if you have any suggestions, please feel free to let me know. Maybe this can turn into a series where I model my subscribers' suggestions. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you all in the next video.